Welcome to this overview of Lens Studio, Snap's AR development software. With Lens Studio, you can build AR experiences, which we call Lenses, for Snapchat, for any mobile or web application through CameraKit, or for Spectacles, our AR glasses. I'm Chris, I'm an AR engineer here at Snap, and today I'll be walking you through some of the platform essentials and game-changing new features. So with that, let's jump into Lens Studio to see what's new. The first thing you'll notice when we launch Lens Studio is drastically improved loading times and a revamped home screen. In the home screen, you can keep track of your projects, get easily set up with building for different platforms, and find sample projects that showcase some of the exciting new features that Lens Studio has to offer. Speaking of exciting features, let's get started with looking at Generative AI Suite and the addition of plugin support. Our aim with the Gen AI Suite is to ease creation for AR creators at every step and make it even faster to deliver on your vision. So what have we added? Well, first up, you can now create the next trending selfie lens with your very own ML face effect. This allows you to generate a highly realistic ML model that's unique every time. Next up, we have also added head morph, which allows you to unlock character creation like space aliens, wizards, monsters, and more with a text to image prompt that generates 3D animated character heads using our face mesh technology. We have also added Immersive ML, which allows you to generate a custom stylization that transforms the user's face, body, and surroundings in real time. You can become a Bob's Burgers character, enter into a Van Gogh painting, or whatever you dream up. We also have 3D asset generation, where you can enter a text prompt to generate a 3D model complete with materials. You can provide reference images to ensure it matches the aesthetic you're going for, and import that directly into Lens Studio. Additionally, Lens Studio includes PBR material generation and texture generation. This allows you to create a PBR material for any 3D model that you input. So you can use the 3D asset you created with the 3D asset generation tool, quickly generate a few additional materials for it, add a generated background texture, and your asset creation pipeline is complete. Now that's already a lot of new features to remember, but we made it even easier to get help thanks to our new AI assistant. We trained an AI model on all of our documentation and learning materials so you can get help even easier. This is a great resource for getting answers to questions on getting started, figuring out the function of something in the editor, or even getting some help with debugging a script, all without leaving Lens Studio. All of these Gen AI features were built using our new plugin system, which in itself is going to be a real game changer for your workflow. Lens Studio plugins are written in JavaScript using a new editor API, which exposes the data of the editor and the open project, such as the scene and asset information, to you as a developer. This means that you can really start to fine-tune the creator experience to suit your needs. So in addition to those Gen AI features mentioned, here are a few more plugins that we think you'll find really useful. We know a lot of you already create UI layouts in Figma today, so we partnered with Figma to create a plugin that imports any frame you have directly as UI in Lens Studio, with the proper scene hierarchy and transforms already set up. Additionally, if you ever felt like your project is getting too big, your code too confusing, and you're not sure what connects to what anymore, well, Andrew Douglas from Weird Eye Studio created the perfect plugin for you, the Flowy Lens Visualization plugin, which creates a flowchart of the scripts in a web view directly in Lens Studio. Plugins like these are incredibly useful because your lenses are getting more complex. So with that, we are also excited to share a few other new features and changes that can help with developing larger AR experiences and allow for better collaboration with teammates working on the same lens project. With Lens Studio, you can now organize your content into multiple scenes. This is especially useful for staying organized when building a front and rear camera experience all within the same lens. And to further help with this, you can now edit your prefabs directly in your own prefab editor view, separate from the rest of the objects in your scene. We've also introduced some additional advanced rendering support and made adding real-time ray tracing to your project as simple as possible. Simply enable the caster checkbox for which objects should be shown in reflections and enable the receiver checkbox for which ones should see those reflections. In addition to this, we have added support for Gaussian splatting. You can use any existing app that allows you to scan an object or environment as a splat to output a PLY file, and you can drag that directly into Lens Studio to add it to your project. In addition to these visual changes, we have now completely redesigned our animation tools to provide wider flexibility for the animations you can create. We now have the Animation Curve Editor, which allows you to animate various properties of an object without needing to create separate animations in an external tool. Additionally, we have added the Animation Player component, which is designed to make playback of animations as easy as possible. On the API front, we have added several new APIs to support dynamic content and to cover even broader use cases. The Friends API allows you to create content that includes the user's friends and the Bitmoji API allows you to pull in 2D or 3D Bitmojis. These APIs can be combined to create very personal and enjoyable experiences for the audience of your lenses. With all of these new features and changes, Lens Studio is made to enable AR experiences that can match the aspirations of your creativity. However, sometimes that creativity takes a whole team to deliver on, which is why we now have Git-friendly project support so you can easily compare changes and collaborate with team members. While we're always adding new features that help you push the boundaries of what's possible with AR, we're also working to improve the developer experience at every turn. So with that, let's look at some of the must-haves that our community has asked for. We're always looking at ways to improve speed of development, and in addition to the GenAI tools we introduced, projects now load 18 times faster. There's no more waiting to get started. We've also added support for multiple Lens Studio instances to be opened at the same time, allowing you to easily copy and paste between projects. For those of you working on connected experiences, we now have support for concurrent device simulation. You can easily preview a connected lens from the perspective of multiple users. For further debugging, we now have real-time inspection, where you can see the scene hierarchy change dynamically as the lens runs. From there, you can pause the preview and inspect values to make sure everything is going according to plan. In addition to real-time inspection, we now also have dynamic asset preview, allowing you to better visualize the assets in your project without needing to add them to the scene. And oh yeah, last but definitely not least, we have added TypeScript support, so you can now choose to develop your lenses in JavaScript, TypeScript, or a combination of the two. Thank you for tuning into this platform overview. As always, we're available on the SnapAR Discord, and with all of these new features, there's a lot to discuss, so please reach out to us there. In addition, we want to continue to build Lens Studio to fit your needs and use cases, so continue to provide feature requests and feedback in user voice. Thank you for watching. We look forward to seeing what you create.